Hello and welcome. In this lesson, we'll be looking at how to play for Elise on the piano with note names and chords in this slow and easy piano tutorial. We'll go through the piece measure by measure, and we'll talk about a few alternatives so you can truly make this piece your own. Don't forget to snag your free 100-day practice challenge. And don't forget to like, subscribe, and hit the notification bell so you won't miss a lesson. So if you're ready, let's get started. The first chord of for Elise is the E major, or you can play it as the E major seventh chord. So the notes in the E major seventh chord are E, G sharp, B, and D. That's the seventh. And here's the melody, which I'm sure you recognize. That is the first opening chord. Moving on to chord number two is A minor. The notes in A minor are A, C, and E. So you have in measure three, we're going back to the E major or E major seventh, and again those notes are E, G sharp, B, and D. Now imagine this. All you have to do when you're going to the next chord is go back to the A minor chord, which you've already played. So in measure four, you're playing A, C, and E. Measure five, it's a repeat of measure two, so we're playing the E major seventh. The notes are E, G sharp, B, and D. Now, if you haven't guessed by now, there is just a moving back and forth between the E major seventh and the A minor chord. So in measure six, we're again back in A minor. Measure seven, we're in the E major seventh, and the notes are E, G sharp, B, and D. And we're reverting back to the A minor. Now, between measures one and measure eight, all we have done is we basically shifted between the E major seventh chord, so E, G sharp, B, and D, and the A minor chord, which is A, C, and E. So if you can memorize these two chords, E major seventh and A major seventh, and then all you have to do is just add the melody on top. Minor, and then you're back at E major seventh, E minor, E major, E minor. Now this is where things change. This is the first time that we're going to hear the C major chord. In the key of A minor, you have the C major chord, and C major is a very basic chord. I'm sure you're familiar with it, but just to review, the notes are C, E, and G. So the melody, we're moving from A back in measure A, C major. Now we're going to play a G major chord, or you can play it as a G seventh because the melody has the F. So the notes in the G major chord are G, E, and D. Now we're going back to that very familiar A minor chord, so A, C, and E. And guess what? We're back to our pattern again, fluctuating between A minor, and if you said E major seventh, you are correct. So E, G sharp, B, and D. Measure 13 is just a repeat of the beginning. So the E major seventh chord, E, G sharp, B, and D, to A minor, so A, C, and E, that's the chord. Fill in the melody, E major, E, G sharp, B, and D, fill in the melody. Now, if you've guessed it, we're gonna go back to the A minor chord again. Yes, again, I know it's repetitive, but actually it just makes it easier for you to learn. So A minor, the notes are A, C, and E. E major or E major seventh. E, G sharp, B, and D. And finally, to finish out the piece, all you need to do now is just move from the A minor chord to the E major or E major seventh, whichever one, E, G sharp, B, and D. And finally, to end the piece, we're going to end it on A minor. Congratulations, you've completed this lesson. See you in the next lesson.